If you're thinking about launching an online course, or perhaps you already have one, and you're on a closed platform, we need to talk about WordPress, because WordPress gets a bad reputation in the online course community. Oh, it's complex, it's difficult to set up, and you know what? Some of those things are true. But thanks to the sponsor of today's video, there's a new option for people who can still maintain control of their online course website, but don't necessarily have to go through all of the headaches to get started. I'm talking about LearnDash. Now, LearnDash is an established player in the online course market. They are trusted by huge companies all over the world. But LearnDash is a WordPress plugin, and it costs $200 a year, and you typically still have to pay for hosting and all of the other WordPress plugins that you need to make everything go. But now with LearnDash Cloud, they have this amazing offer. For only $25 a month if you pay annually, you can have an amazing WordPress website with LearnDash pre-installed. You don't need to pay extra for the license, and everything is ready to go as soon as you click a button. This $25 a month plan is actually going to let you have up to 1,000 students. And if you grow to 5,000 students, which is a ton of students, if you run an online course business, you know it's hard to get 5,000 paying customers. The next plan up is only $41 a month. This is insane. But how's the hosting? Is it good quality? Is it something fast? Is it going to be a good experience for my students? Well, let's find out. All right, here we go. I'm gonna check out and buy the starter plan. I'm gonna pay monthly, so it's gonna be $29. If I like this, I can upgrade to yearly, which will be an average of $25 a year. All right, I'm in, and as you can see, my site is being provisioned. I get a little notice up here as well as right here. So this is really dead simple. I don't need to know anything about WordPress so far. Click a button, I'm gonna have a site in a moment. Now, while my site is spinning up, it's worth noting that I'm not only getting hosting and LearnDash pre-installed for my $29 per month, I'm also getting their Pro Panel plugin. Pro Panel itself is typically $49 a year, and this is the plugin that you can use to keep track of what your students are actually doing on your website. So you can see who's completed assignments, who sent in quizzes, how far people are making it inside of courses, when they've logged in. You get a ton of detail inside of Pro Panel. If you're worried about retention and people wanting to return your online courses, Pro Panel is a great idea because now you can see who's struggling, who's failing to log in and actually do the work. This can give you a big insight into what's working in your course and what's not. LearnDash Cloud is also going to take care of a lot of the annoying things associated with WordPress, such as automatic daily backups. So you don't have to go find a backup plugin, track it down, connect it up to some storage thing. It's going to take a whole afternoon for you to figure out if you're not a WordPress person. And this is done for you, so you don't have to even think about it. You're also gonna get iTheme Security Pro, which is typically $100 a year. This will help keep your site secure. When you add together the cost of Pro Panel, LearnDash Cloud, LearnDash itself, which is $200 a year, you're gonna see that you're actually saving money and getting the hosting for free by going with LearnDash Cloud. But the best part of all of this is that you're not running some closed off system. You can still extend LearnDash Cloud just like it was any other WordPress site, because it is. It's just a WordPress site. You could build out everything here on LearnDash Cloud. And then if a few years later you decide, you know what, this hosting platform isn't right for me, you can simply grab your WordPress site and have it migrated over to any other hosting provider that you choose. Nothing is locked in. You have an open ecosystem here. All right, so my LearnDash site is spun up. You can see they gave me kind of a funny URL. This is just a temporary placeholder, and I can connect my own domain. IntentStageChairs.mylearndash.com. It's got a ring to it. To connect my own domain, I can click this little button right here and then choose domains from the menu. Right here, I can buy a domain right on LearnDash. They'll configure all of the DNS stuff for me. So if you don't know how to do that or you don't already have a domain, they make it super easy. If you're like me and a huge nerd, I've got a ton of domains I'm not even using. I can click right here and connect my own domain. So I'm back over in the site tab, and this is where I get all of the login information to get into the back end of my website so I can begin customizing it. We've got FTP credentials, so if you want to upload files directly to your server, you can do that. But most people are just going to go right to the admin area, and you've got your first time login credentials right here, where you can just click a button, copy and paste this into your browser, and then you'll be able to log in and start adding your course content right away. They do have this handy one-click login feature. It says you can only use this once. Let's try it out. And boom, just like that, I am taken to a setup wizard to get going with LearnDash. Now, this is not the typical WordPress experience. You see a lot of people complaining about WordPress because they download it, they install it on some expensive server, and then they don't know what to do next. It's a whole learning curve. LearnDash Cloud is making this as easy as possible. I think this is actually a great direction for the WordPress ecosystem. It's getting fragmented. It's getting really fragmented out there. And so if you're going to fragment, why not provide a great user experience for your customers? All right, let's go through this setup wizard. First, we can set our username and password. This is important. We don't want to use the default username and password that LearnDash generated for us, so let's create a new one. Typically, I like to use something like my email address. And make sure you use a password manager so you don't have password 123 as your password. Security hygiene saves lives, kids. All right, let's move to step two, which looks like it's the site details. I'm going to give my site a name and a tagline. Now they want me to upload my logo. I wonder if it takes SVGs. It looks like it's going to work. Ah, no such luck. All right, PNG it is. Let's hit next. Now we're going to set up our courses, and basically they're just trying to gather some information so that they can best set up LearnDash on your behalf and not make you struggle with all of the settings. So the first question here is, how many courses are you going to have? Just one or multiple? Don't worry if you're not sure of the answer to this. Just choose one for now if you're getting started, and you can still add as many courses as you want later on. Next, they're asking how complex your courses are going to be. Most of the time, people are just creating simple courses with video and some text along, but maybe you want to add a certificate program, or you're doing time tests to make sure that people are getting certified and can answer the questions in a certain amount of time. You can even do cohorts with LearnDash, so you can learn in a group. This is a great modern way to interact through an online course. For me, I'm old school, I'm gonna go with simple. Next, they ask if you wanna charge for your course. Now, this is dead simple. If you already have a Stripe account, and most people do these days, just click on connect right here, and you can log into Stripe and get going right away. And if you don't have a Stripe account, it only takes a second to set one up, enter in your banking information, and you can start accepting payments right away. Now, if you have a little bit of time and patience, my preferred method for selling online courses is actually to use WooCommerce, because here we can really customize the sales experience and we can offer things like bump offers, upsells, and downsells, and take advantage of all of the automation plugins available in the WordPress ecosystem. For the sake of simplicity in this video and to get going, I'm gonna turn off payments right now. We can always enable that later on if we decide to set it up. All right, now we're on the summary page. We're almost done with the setup wizard, and they're telling us everything they're gonna do for us. They're gonna create a registration page, a success page. So registrations where people get signed up for the course, and then they're gonna be redirected to the success page, which says, you know, thank you for registering for the course and gives any pertinent details there. And then we are also going to be resetting our password and profile. And everything else here is optional add-ons that they can do, and they're all toggled off based on my answers. So that little questionnaire was actually deciding which plugins they installed on our behalf. No sorting through the WordPress maze of, you know, choosing which plugins are best for you. They're gonna ask you some questions and configure it for you. All right, let's hit save and complete. All right, we are through their first step in the setup guide, which is to go through their setup wizard. Now next, we have to design our site. This is where you can jump off and just start using WordPress if you're already an experienced WordPress user. However, if you're not, or maybe you're just wanting to take some shortcuts, you can go ahead and choose a starter template. We'll open this up and you're gonna see a huge list of amazing looking templates. I can see what they're gonna look like by clicking on the preview button, and it opens it up into a nice big view so I can kind of get the feel of what the website is gonna look like. There are templates for literally everything. We've got a coding template right here. This is great if you are a developer and maybe you don't really wanna put your face out there. You do a lot of screen recordings. This is gonna be very, very developer focused, code focused. You have a beautiful design ready to go with just a couple of clicks. Or maybe you're a yoga teacher and you want something beautiful and zen. Well, we've got this layout here. And I should mention that these are not just home pages, they're entire websites. So we've got an About Me page, we've got our course list right here. This template has a publications page, so if you've written a book, this might be a great one to choose, even if you don't do yoga, because you could just customize the images to be appropriate to your subject matter. And this example also has a physical storefront, so maybe you're a yoga teacher that actually has a studio and you're branching out into online courses. This would be the perfect fit for you. All right, for me, I'm gonna go with this first one that I looked at. I love the colorful background, and I think I could just drop my image in right here to get going right away. So I'm gonna select this template, choose next, and now I can choose my fonts and colors. This is where I can start to make a template actually feel on brand. Now, none of the selections that we're making here are permanent. You can always go in and change fonts or styles after the fact, but I really love this little font picker. They've combined different fonts that work good together, and you can see as I just click through the different presets here, I'm really changing the look and feel of the entire website. If you're curious what actual fonts they're using, just hover over one of the presets and a little tooltip will appear and tell you the name of the font. All right, I happen to use this font, Rubik, here on my actual website. So I'm gonna go with this preset, and let's move to the next section where we can choose our colors. Same deal as with the fonts here. We can go through and we can choose a different template pack that we like, but then after the fact, we can always go in and customize it to our specific brand colors. You can see this is definitely changing the look of the site. So I went to this kind of dark background and everything changed over here. I'm gonna go back up to this light one and you can just see which one you like best. As I scroll down, you can see, oh right, that really changes the look. All right, I have a red color in my logo, so I'm gonna go with this preset right here, and I kinda like the white background personally. I just generally prefer light mode over dark mode, but you know, you do you. All right, let's go ahead and choose this set, and we're gonna go ahead and launch our site here. All right, everything's loaded up. It looks good to me. Let's save and continue. Nice choices. I like that they're buttering me up already. Template building process is going by super fast. This is only taking like 3 seconds. Importing the demo data. Just enough time for a sip of coffee. All right, the template's been built, ready to use. Let's go ahead and check out our site. Boom, there it is. We have a live site. Now, if I'd connected Stripe in the setup wizard, I can import a course into LearnDash and I'd be ready to accept payments right away. And what are we like, 10 minutes into the video? I do wanna show you basically how to customize this. So let's get my image in here and I'm gonna change the button color because it's got kind of a weird hover here. So we're gonna look at some very basic editing just to get a feel for it. If you're new to WordPress, it's a lot easier than you think it's gonna be. All right, I'm gonna choose edit page. All right, so here is our editor. Let's go ahead and make a few changes. So Richard is about to go away here. I'm sure you are a great CEO, Richard, but let's click on his picture. And then I'm gonna choose the little pencil icon here where I can replace it with my own image. I'm using a Mac, and so I've got this picture of myself right here, and I'm gonna try and remove the background. So I don't know if you've seen this before, I can just simply right click and then go to quick actions, remove background. And boom, just like magic, there we go. I've got a nice image of myself with no background. All right, I'm just gonna drop this right into WordPress here. I'll choose add to gallery. And now, because this is actually an image gallery meant to display multiple images, I'm gonna click off Richard there. He is gone. Let's go ahead and update the gallery. Boom, there I am. I am now Richard. I didn't realize there was another image here. Let's go ahead and remove this one as well. All right, looks great. This suit looks super custom within just a few clicks. All right, next let's work on this button color. I don't really like the fact that it hovers and changes colors. So I'm gonna go ahead and just click on it. And then I'll go over to style right here. And this is where I can choose all of the different colors for my buttons. Now you'll notice right here that the color is actually blank, which is kind of confusing because obviously the color is red. That's because these colors are set inside of the theme. So the theme can kind of set a standard templated version of what buttons will look like. And if you want to override them on a case-by-case basis, you can do so right here by choosing the actual button you're using and then overriding it. Now, if I want to change the hover color, I'll just click on this tab right here that says hover, and then go to background color, and I can change it to be anything that I want. I'll choose this red, and let's just make it a little bit lighter. Now, if I hover, there we go. I've got that light red color. Super easy. However, other buttons are still gonna have that blue color. So to change it overall, I need to do so at the theme level. I'm gonna update this page and let me show you how to do that. After we're done, we're gonna import our first course and begin selling. So we're back on our website and instead of choosing edit page, I'm gonna choose customize. Under colors and fonts, I'm going to choose buttons. Now here you can see my background colors, red and then this kind of purplish button. I'm gonna change that hover color. I'm gonna start off with the same red color and just make it, let's go a little bit darker in this case. Now I'll hit publish. We'll close out of the customizer. And if we check out our other buttons down here, you can see that they now have the nicer, in my opinion, background color. All right, that's customizing WordPress. It's actually very easy. WordPress has come a long way. If you haven't seen it in a few years, definitely give it another look. I will admit that WordPress gets way easier when you start with a service like LearnDash Cloud. It's going to give you that nice starting point. All of the plugins are installed and basically configured just as you like. Top it off with a starter template, and man, we're in easy mode here. However, we're not sacrificing anything. Remember, I can still customize this exactly as I need, and I can take advantage of the entire ecosystem of WordPress plugins so that if I wanna add a sales funnel down the line, I don't have to wait for a closed platform to add that feature and make it available to me. All right, let's check out LearnDash, the actual star of the show. I'm gonna go to the dashboard, and then under LearnDash LMS, I'll go to courses. Now, LearnDash has some amazing new features here, like creating a course outline from AI. But what I'm actually gonna show you is this feature right here, which is creating from a video playlist. If your course videos are on YouTube, Vimeo, or Wistia, you can actually just import the playlist and LearnDash will do all of the work for you. This is a playlist that I made way back in 2020. It was an online course that I released called WordPress Made Easy. I'm gonna be updating this later this year, but for now, I wanna upload it to this LearnDash site. So I'm in the playlist, I'll click on the triple dots, and I'm gonna choose Get Shareable Link. Now that's copied to my clipboard. Back over in LearnDash, I'm just gonna paste in the playlist URL. It says load data from YouTube. Yes, please. Okay, so it tells me it's going to create a course based off the name of the playlist, and then it's gonna take each video in the playlist and create a dedicated lesson for it. This is amazing. It's gonna save me a ton of time. There's just a few options to choose, and that's related to access to the course. So if I set it as open, anyone can visit the website and just start watching the course. No need to log in. Free courses are still free, but you have to log in to begin the course. So people can't just stumble on your website and start taking your course. You at least make them create an account so that maybe you can sell them something later. If you're using LearnDash's integration with Stripe, you can click Buy Now or Recurring and then set your price, either a one-time cost under Buy Now or obviously a recurring price under Recurring, and you can set your billing cycle here. So if you wanted to charge people monthly to access your course material, you could do that right here. I gotta say that using the Buy Now option and just connecting up Stripe through LearnDash is by far the easiest way to get going selling an online course while still living in an open source ecosystem, which is critical. The last option is closed, and this is what I use mostly because I tend to sell courses through WooCommerce. If you're selling through WooCommerce, you set it to closed, and then you'll create a connection between WooCommerce and LearnDash. For today, I'll set the course as free, and then I just have one more option to choose here, whether or not I want people to jump around in the course. So linear means they have to go from lesson one to lesson two to lesson three. Freeform means, hey, I wanna find out what's in lesson one, and then I don't really care about two or three, I'm gonna go right to four. And that's usually what I'll choose. All right, let's create this course. Boom, there it is. There was no delay. I thought it was gonna take a second to load or something, but it's just done. Let's check it out. All right, here it is. This is my course. I'm gonna go ahead and see what it looks like. And there we go, our first lesson with the video. Now, there's one more thing I like to do every time I create a LearnDash course. This is super easy, optional, but I think you're gonna like what it looks like. Now, this isn't bad. I wouldn't say this is a bad looking online course, but it's not as good as I think it could be. So what I like to do is go over to LearnDash LMS, go down to settings, and then choose focus mode on. This is gonna get rid of all of the other distractions, and it's also going to give me a nice sidebar that people are very accustomed to when they're taking online courses on other major platforms. All right, let's save these options. I'll go back to my courses, choose view, and now it looks the same right here, but let's open up a lesson. There we go, way better. Now I can quickly jump between lessons over here on the sidebar. You can see everything's loading up super fast. Hosting online courses is actually very taxing on servers. You typically need a really beefy server to do so. But as I'm moving around this LearnDash site, everything is really, really snappy. You can see the plugins that come pre-installed here. I can go under tools, look at the site health, maybe get a little data about what's going on. This is for the nerds checking this out. You can see there's 2 gigs of memory allocated to this WordPress website. Not bad considering we're paying $29 a month. Part of the reason I think it's going so quickly is Object Cache Pro. This is a very expensive plugin. This plugin alone is $950 per year, and it's coming for free on our LearnDash Cloud website. All right, I just opened up a private browser so we can see what this page looks like for a visitor. Now I've done nothing to customize it. It looks really great here. I can see the price is set to free, but if I set up Stripe, the price would show right here. I'm gonna go ahead and log in to enroll. All right, I created an account, I logged in, and now I'm ready to take this course. Boom, I'm in. I can start watching videos and learning right here on this website. It's pretty amazing. Now, there are definitely a few more things I'd want to do to smooth out the registration process, such as taking advantage of LearnDash's registration page. I didn't have that configured. And I'd probably also redirect people to a nice member dashboard so they could see a list of their courses that they've purchased from me. If you want to see more content about LearnDash, make sure you leave a comment down below, and I'll make dedicated videos on addressing those issues. Now, overall, I could not be more stoked about the LearnDash Cloud experience. I think it's just super fast, super powerful, and the value is out of this world. I gotta be honest, this kind of scares me because my day job is hosting online course websites and I charge a lot more than $29 a month. You better believe it. So if you're interested in LearnDash Cloud, I've got a link down below. Go ahead and check that out. I appreciate you checking out this video. Feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions or comments. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next video.